Stay focused and energized using G Fuel. You can use the discount code OGXRays to get 10% off your entire order. Yo guys, what's up with Texters? Welcome back to another video. So what I have for you guys today is actually talking about something that's pretty interesting, something I've been thinking about, and maybe you guys will also find interesting, in that maybe Advanced Warfare was already showing us things that maybe Sledgehammer Games is thinking about doing for their next game. It could be a couple of things here. It could be either Sledgehammer was trying to make fans happy, or again, it could be hints at what Sledgehammer Games plans on doing next, or what they were hoping for to do next. So here's what I mean. So let's go ahead and jump into the topic real quick, because I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. I think it's going to be a very interesting discussion piece, and more than anything, it's just something to think about. So drop a like, drop a favorite if you enjoy the video, if you agree with me and that this is pretty cool, and also if you are new, if you want to see more content like this in the future, make sure you subscribe. But anyway, let's go ahead and jump into it. So the big thing that everyone is talking about is that Sledgehammer Games will be working on a new Vietnam War game, or a boots on the ground older war type game. Now the reason everyone thinks this is because Sledgehammer Games, before they made Advanced Warfare, were planning on making a third person Vietnam War game for Call of Duty. That got scrapped and they ended up working on AW, but the idea of a past war game is something that they wanted to do very much. Now here's another thing. Sledgehammer Games also was the first one to see that the advanced movement was something that fans didn't really like. So while Advanced Warfare was a very unique game and that it brought a new movement style, and a lot of people liked it, a lot of people hated it, it was the very first game that saw, hey, people don't really like the direction that this whole futuristic thing is going. It might be time to go back in time. So they are the first ones who have the opportunity to stop this futuristic trend and do a past war game. So those are two reasons that a lot of people think that Sledgehammer Games is actually going to make a boots on the ground older COD. Now, some things that might actually support this, and we've already, you know, had leaks already of supposedly the next one is codenamed Stronghold and Lethal Combat. Well, there might actually be hints already that we saw throughout the year for Black Ops 3, along with even for Advanced Warfare when it was a game. Now, here's the thing. Advanced Warfare had a lot of DLC weapons when the game was out, and only, I believe, there were three that were energy shot weapons or futuristic weapons. The ones being the AE4, the Ohm, and then also the Cell 3 Cauterizer, which was a zombies weapon that they brought over to multiplayer. But apart from that, all the other weapons are older weapons. We had the STG-44, the AK-47, the M16, the lever action, the M1 Garand, the MP40, the Sten. These were all weapons that are older weapons. The SVO, you know, all these other weapons are all pretty much weapons that were used starting from World War II all the way through the Vietnam War. Specifically, during the Vietnam War, all these weapons were in use. The AK-47, the STG, the M16, the M1 Garand, you know, the Sten, all these other weapons were all weapons that were used during the Vietnam War, which is very interesting because, again, Advanced Warfare was a futuristic game. It's a futuristic game. There were a lot of energy weapons. It was the first kind of attempt at doing energy weapons. We had the AE4, the Ohm, and now that I remember, also the Repulsor was another one of these energy weapons, but those were it. There were three energy weapons, and then after that, there was mostly, or just overwhelmingly, a lot of regular ballistic weapons that were specifically weapons that had been used during the Vietnam War, which again is a game that Sledgehammer Games was planning on doing before they ended up scrapping it, a third-person Vietnam War game. And Call of Duty has never done the Vietnam War. We've done World War II, we've done the Cold War, that's what Black Ops was, we've done World War I, I believe, but we haven't specifically focused in on the Vietnam War. So it's very interesting, again, and just think about it, that Activision, and more specifically Sledgehammer Games, added weapons that were in Vietnam War as the majority of DLC weapons for Advanced Warfare, which is a futuristic weapon, which is mind-blowing to me. Now, there could be some reasons for this. It could be, again, like I was saying, maybe Sledgehammer Games saw that people weren't really enjoying the energy weapons and they were like, fine, we'll add in a whole bunch of older weapons so that people are a little bit more complacent. They're not as angry with the movement system or the futuristic setting. So they added the Sten, the STG-44, the AK-47, the M16, the MP40. They added all these weapons maybe in order to kind of quell the anger that was in the community Or it could be number two, they were testing out weapons that they knew that maybe in the future they were going to be working on. Maybe over the course of AW, they saw people really hate futuristic weapons. They hate futuristic Call of Duties. Maybe our next one's going to be an older COD. Let's see what we can do with these regular weapons. So maybe they were testing out their ability to make weapons that are older. So they started putting together the M1911. They started putting together the Sten, the AK-47, all these older weapons. Maybe they were trying to see how good they were at making these weapons, because again, these aren't just your futuristic laser shooting weapons. These are actual weapons that needed to go out there, get the sound, and really get the feel for it right. If it was a futuristic laser type weapon, they can do whatever they want. They can make up their own sounds. They can make up their own crazy weapons. But when you're going with older weapons, you need to be as faithful to the real life weapons as you can. So in essence, because they were doing these older weapons, they were making it harder on themselves because they needed to try to replicate them, as opposed to making their own weird energy weapon where they would have less restrictions and honestly have more of an opportunity to kind of do whatever the hell they wanted. So again, why would they purposely put themselves in a situation where more work and time needed to go into it, unless they were practicing, getting ready for their next game and seeing, yo, let's see what we got. Can we do these older weapons? And I might add, I thought they were pretty successful, apart from the M16, which just had a disgusting iron sight. But most of these weapons were fun to use, and they kind of, in my opinion, prove that they're able to do older style weapons. Now, to finish this off, I want to set one example of maybe this is a possibility. Black Ops 3 had a shotgun, an energy shotgun that they released called the Banshee. Now, this was a weapon that I believe a lot of people really enjoyed. It was a pretty cool weapon. It shot basically its pellet in like an actual straight beam, like a weird blue bulb. And then after this weapon came out in Black Ops 3, we found out that the Banshee was a weapon in Infinite Warfare. So not only was it a weapon that was in BL3, but it was also a weapon that was in Infinite Warfare. The opinion in the community being, or the thought process being, they put in the Banshee so that people could get used to these energy style weapons as DLC weapons, and just to get a feel for it, so that when Infinite Warfare would come out, they would be used to the idea of energy weapons. So in essence, the Banshee was in BO3 to kind of lay the groundwork for Infinite Warfare, and maybe that's exactly what Sledgehammer Games also did. They were testing their ability to work on older style weapons while at the same time getting a feel for what the community thought of these weapons themselves, or subconsciously putting this idea of an older COD in their head. So we'll definitely see. I wanted to talk about that because I thought it was pretty interesting. Give me your thoughts, your opinions down in the comments section below. I honestly think that they're working on an older style COD, and maybe these new DLC weapons that they added over the course of AW and even over the course of BL3 was to test or lay the groundwork for what they're planning on doing in their next game. Anyway, so thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, drop a like, drop a favorite. It does get the content out there. It is appreciated. And if you are new, if you want to see even more videos like these, I'm going to have a ton more Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare, Advanced Warfare, and just Call of Duty games in general, some videos. So make sure you subscribe and you turn on notifications by clicking the little bell icon. I will see you guys in the next upload. Follow me on Twitter. Check out my gaming channel. I'll see you guys next time. I'm out. Peace.